What's up, Padre Valley? I'm Ethan Brackenfeld.
And I'm Kazi DeBonas. Welcome to What's Up, our weekly show about what's going on here at the high school.
Welcome back from winter break. Kazi, how was your break?
It was good. You go snowboarding?
I did, and the snow was crazy.
Speaking of sports, we sent Amy and Josue to talk to Dora Placentia and Trent Kroll about sports diversity here at the high school.
So I'm working with the district to get more diversity into the sports, so to get more like Hispanics and other cultures involved in sports and playing sports.
And when we talk about demographics, a lot of people think about race. I think about economically disadvantaged.
So some barriers there are like the money or the transportation, as well as some kids have to babysit or do other responsibilities.
Yeah, like, another big barrier is the sign-up registration online. There is a button at the top of that you can click to change the whole thing to Spanish that is kind of hidden. So make sure that you know how to do that if you really want to do that.
We are gathering data. So they send out like questionnaires. We are trying to get advertisements on Radio Tierra to tell them what sports are being offered right now.
Starting at middle school levels, making everything accessible. So definitely from an economical standpoint, keeping things cheaper, having options to do fundraising. So it's something that we are focused on and we try to promote.
So I want to be able to come back in a couple years and see like a diverse team play.
So the water polo team is pretty much a bunch of white guys or white girls if you're on the girls water polo team. The last few years we get a lot of foreign exchange students, but now there's pretty much no diversity.
I think there's a lot of diversity in I play tennis in our tennis team because it's mostly Latinos, but I mean, it's not as diverse when we play against other teams because it's mainly white.
So there's not that much diversity, but I don't really care. I get along with everyone, but that would be pretty cool if we had more different people playing, you know.
Go Eagles!
Have you ever been put inside the cop car?
I played the fifth.
Well, Izzy and Jordan asked the staff the same question.
Dun dun.
Yes. Well, it was actually for an experiment.
Really?
Yeah. So it was actually, I didn't get in trouble. I actually ran from the cops once, but I didn't get caught. But I got, should I actually say that? And then the cops did an experiment on me and put me in the cop car in the back. So
I'm pretty nervous right now, so let's do it.
Have you ever been put in the back of a police car?
No, I have not. Whew!
Have you ever been put in the back of a police car?
Oh, damn it. Maybe. Yes.
Yeah?
Yes. Gosh, you guys.
Have you ever been put in the back of a police car?
I have never been put in the back of a police car. I am happy to say.
No, I haven't. Sorry, I have no fun stories. Oh, I sort of wish I had. No.
Have you ever been put in the back of a police car?
No, thankfully.
Okay, thank you. Put in the back of a police car?
No, I don't think I have, actually. I've been in the back of one, like cleaning my own, but I've never been put in the back of a police car.
Ask him.
Have you ever been put in the back of a police car?
Oh, not because I did something bad, because I volunteered or I wanted to get in there. Oh, I put on the vest and stuff. The only thing I don't think I've got to do, they don't let me hold the taser or the gun. I've tried to ask Ives, he says no.
Here are some highlights from the talent staff's winter break.
Thanks for watching. Come back next week.
And we'll tell you what's up. All right.